Hello everyone, today I'm going to show you how to do a simple dialogue like this. Like, hello Pika, let me teach you Thai. And when I continue as press A, the dialogue will go on. So in this tutorial, I will start with the basic of the text nodon, and then like a single dialogue, followed by a continuous dialogue. Before we can create dynamic text in the game, we have to understand the text nodon properties first. So I'm going to create one text nodon for a demo. Let's go to the game screen to take a look at it. Yeah, now it shows text object. Then if I go to the settings and then I remove visible. Now we cannot see anything. But if I connect a texture, and then connect this one to the text object. Yeah, now I can see the floating text. So with texture nodon, we can control whether this text should be shown or not. Let's say that I want to show this text when button B is pressed. I can create a button B and then send a signal to the texture visibility. Here I'm going to send a signal from B to visible part. Yeah, so now when I'm pressing B, the text will be shown. But if I release B, the text will disappear. So with this, we know that we can control the visibility of the text box by the visibility of the texture nodon. Here is the current setting. I have the walking Pikachu, and if you want to know how to do this, you can find the link in the description box below. And then let's say when I press A here, I want the person to start talking to me. Okay, let's get started. This is where I send Pikachu to when the game starts. And here I have prepared of the text box. Like with hello Pika, let me teach you Thai, sawaddi, khopkun. So to show this text box on the game screen, I will need the head nodon. And because the head nodon can only connect one object to it, I need a box as a proxy. Then I'm going to connect this box to the head nodon. Then I go to the box settings. And then I remove everything except visible and movable. For the connection point, I'm going to change it to be from center to Z positive. Okay, let's take a look at where the box is. Yeah. So the box appears at the center. Let me try connecting the text to the box. Then I go to the text box properties. The text display size should be Z negative. The properties should be only visible and movable. The connection point depends where you want the text to be. In this case, I want the text to be at the bottom. So I'm changing the connection point to be from Y positive to Y negative. So with this, like, it will be under the box. Let's take a look. Yeah, so now I can see hello Pika here. And yeah, because now it's still too high, right? So let's increase the size on Y axis of this box. Let's take a look again. Yeah, so let's say I'm satisfied with this position. Okay. Okay, now that we can find the desired position, let's go to the box, go to the settings, and then remove visible. For the text, I do not want to show this all the time. So let's go to the settings and then remove visible. Then I'm going to connect a texture to the text box to control whether to show or not to show the text. I only want to show this text when my Pikachu is here and I press A. So I'm going to add the touch sensor to detect whether Pikachu is here or not. Go to the settings and then check for Pikachu. But I'm using UFO for Pikachu, so yeah, I have to check for Pikachu. No, so I have to check for UFO. And then I have to remove visible. Output timing is while touched. Close it. Then I also need to turn on this only when button A is pressed. So I'm going to add button A. And then end condition. Then when this end is true, I will set this texture to be visible, which also means that the text will be visible as well. Okay, let's test. So now there is no text, but after I walk to here, then I press A. Yeah, I can see Hello Pika. When I release A, nothing is showing. But I want to show a sequence of text. How to do that? Here we are going to create a sequence of dialogue. So to do that, we have to connect all these text to the box first. And then I'm going to add texture nodons to all of them. How to know which texture should be visible? To do that, we need a help from Move Marker Nodon. And yeah, but how many squares should it have? So basically, each square will represent the state of the dialogue. So the first square means like no text have been read. The second square means this text is read. The third one is here, fourth means we are reading here, and then fifth is we are reading here, and the sixth one is here, and the seventh one is when we finish the dialogue. So yeah, we need to create a marker nodon with seven squares. Let me rotating this. Next, we need boost eyes nodons to read the marker value. And then as mentioned earlier, the first bull's eyes means nothing is red. The second one means the first text is red. So I have to connect this one to the visible part of the first text. And I'm going to remove the earlier link. And for the third square, it means I'm reading the second text. And so on. But right now we cannot move the marker nodon right. Let me add a counter. So basically, this counter will memorize which square we are being at. So I'm going to go to the settings, and the starting value is 0. The range is from 0 to 6, because there are 7 squares in total, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Like there are 7 numbers for 6. But this marker can only move from 0 to 1, so we need a map. And then we are going to map from 0 to 6 to 0 to 1. Change this to 6, and then output range to be from 0 to 1. I connect this count to map, and then this map to move the marker nodon. Let me reuse this button A, and let's say now for testing, I want to make sure that I keep showing text when A is pressed. I can connect this A to the count up part, but now when I press A, it will move too fast. That's because of the settings, so the output timing should be on press instead. It can only increase by 1. Yeah, so it's like now it is at 0. After I press A, it will be 1, and Hello Pika will be visible. And when it is at 2, let me teach you Thai will be visible. Let's try. Yeah, so now when I press A, I will see Hello Pika, and then the second time it will see Let Me Teach You Thai. Dr. Tham is Sawasdee for hello. So this is a simple idea on how you can create a dynamic text. But let's add this condition back, like we only want to start talking when the character is in front of the person nodon. So I'm going to add this and condition back to here. And let's say I want to reset the conversation when we are outside this touch sensor. So I'm going to add not and then connect to the reset part of the counter. So when the UFO is not touching here, I will reset the counter. Let's try it now. So I'm walking around, if I press A now, nothing happens. But when I press A here, it will start talking like, hello Pika, let me teach you Thai. But when I walk outside, yeah, the text will disappear. And then if I come back here again, I can start talking. Okay, but this looks slightly ugly, right? Let's add some background to this. So I'm going to go to the texture, and then I'm going to change the texture face to be Z negative. Then I'm going to draw some text box. So now your text box can have a background. Of course, you can make it look more pretty than this, but yeah, this is my limit. And then I'm going to copy this for all the other text box. Don't forget to connect the boost eyes marker to those new textures. Okay, let's test our dynamic text. I'm walking to the person, then I would start talking by pressing A. Hello Pika, let me teach you Thai. Sawasdee, hello. Khopkun, thank you. Khopkun for subscribing Jazz Studio. Yeah, thank you. Note that the limitation of this method is that the maximum number of text nodons is only 8. So if you have long dialogue, you will have to use box and texture. For example, I can replace this one with a box instead. So I'm going to create a box. Then I connect this one to the proxy box. I'm going to go to the box settings to remove visible properties. Keep it movable and update the connection point to match other text box, which is Y positive to Y negative. Then I'm linking this texture to this box. Resize it to match the size of the box. Go to the settings to draw some text in. Okay, let's test. So now I start talking with the person. Hello, Pika. Okay. Yeah. And you see like the text box will be shown. But of course, you can make it look better than this. Yeah, and that's the end of today's tutorial. Hope this is useful for your game, especially for RPG type. Lastly, don't forget to like and share. Bye bye and see you next time.